Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
So, in last lecture, we were discussing about the isotype change between IgM and IgD. Okay. So, what we have seen, last lecture, IgM and IgD are coming from the same transcript. Okay. One transcript is there, but IgM and IgD is produced because of alternate splicing. Okay. But there are so many other, there are three more isotypes, and if you consider the subtypes, there are even more, right? How this thing is happening? This is actually not coming to this part here, but the problem in immune system is, I told at the beginning also, they are very, the whole immune system is working together. There is no that this is first or this is second or this is third, right? And no, it is not possible for anybody to tell everything at a time. So I have to decide, or whoever is teaching has to decide, like which one I will tell first. If it is a mathematics, okay, it's fine. I can teach you summation today, okay, addition today. Tomorrow I can teach you subtraction, then multiplication, which is basically the repeat of addition, and then division is the repetition of subtraction. So one by one. It is not that if you have, if it is like this, immunology is like that, when I am teaching you addition, you also need to know how to divide. And which one I have to, I don't know which one I will teach you first, division or the addition. So this kind of problem is always there in immunology. So because whole thing is happening at a time, all are linked or interrelated, or most of them are very much interrelated. So what you may find that something is repeating again. This is also helps sometimes to remind you or recapitulate you. So what is happening is I may repeat something again and again. So to explain or to link actually. Otherwise, discrete things are not always possible for. To understand, I can like what I am teaching you is the isotype switching. Isotype switching is what? Why this IgM is converted to IgA or IgG or IgE? And who is deciding that? This is happening when infection happens. Okay, initially. And you can correlate, like in the primary immune response, I told, or you can read in the book also, that most of the antibody or almost all the antibody is IgM type. Now you can understand why IgM type. Because the genome organization is like that. Immediately after the VDJ, IgM is located. So receptor is always IgM type and IgD type. And when the secretion starts, IgM comes first. So in primary response, the variable region is fixed, but all constant domain is always IgM. This is the reason why in primary immune response, the antibody is all or most of them are IgM type. But secondary infection, they change. Okay, secondary infection, they change. This IgM constant domain will change to IgA type or IgG type or IgE type because effector function is different. Okay, if we need, IgM cannot cross the barrier of placenta. So if all the antibody is IgM type, baby will not be protected inside the mother womb. So some antibody with the same specification of antigen specification need to be converted to some other isotype like IgG or IgA, which can take care of baby inside the placenta. I'm giving just this example because you just see the table how which antibody can do what. If complement activation is needed, initial part, because complement can kill bacteria. So initial infection should be taken care, and you see IgM is more competent in complement activation. In secondary infection, we don't need that much. So other antibodies not that effective as IgM, right? So how this IgM is converted to IgD, this is alternate splicing. But other cases, they are far away, they are not produced by alternate splicing. What is happening? And this is called isotype switching, okay? Again, if you see this, what we have seen here, we have seen this VDJ segment is there, and then again we make this one small, like C mu a small square, C delta small square, but we see something else here. Before this C mu and C delta, you see there is one S mu. There is before C gamma 3, there is S gamma 3, similarly S gamma 1, 2a, 2b, epsilon, alpha. What is this S? S is basically the recombination signal. Again, recombination is coming. S is a recombination signal, it's a similar sequence. And this recombination, I'm not going in detail, recombination means DNA, because in chromosome is not open, right? Chromosome is protected by histone-like protein. It's in the nucleosome. We cannot see naked DNA in, if you open the nucleus. So for recombination or transcription or replication, the DNA should be opened up. So that nucleosome or the histone should fall apart, the naked DNA should come out, then two naked DNA in two places should come together, some protein will help, that is, and this opening of DNA of a particular region is controlled by cytokines. Okay, now you don't know much about the cytokines, so I cannot tell much about the cytokines. So when cytokines are interleukins will study, you will see like which cytokine is doing what, okay, and how it is happening, and recombination mechanism is same. Okay, so what is happening? This S mu, S gamma 1, 2a, 2b, all are the recombination signals. So, keeping one VDJ intact, this S mu and S gamma, this blue and S gamma C can come together. Okay, these two can come together. And again, they make a loop. Okay, what is going to happen? If this recombination happens and this loop eliminate out, what we will see? Next chromosome is like that. So in B cell, there will be a recombination by which mu and delta will be eliminated. And what we will see? The VDJ, what is the next constant domain? Next constant domain is C gamma C. So now in this stage, if this is the genome organization. In this stage, if any transcription happens, what will happen? VDJ along with gamma C as the nearest constant domain. What will be the product of that transcript? We will see same VDJ, but constant region is gamma. So it was C mu at the beginning. Now it is converted to gamma C. Right? So I will see IgG3 as a isotype of the same specific antibody. This is just next to it, but this recombination can happen between far away constant domain. Okay, the constant domain located far away from this VDJ can also join. See here in this, same looping out is going to happen, but here alpha. That means all other constant domain is just in the loop. Here you see once this recombination happens, this gamma and delta is eliminated out from the chromosome. Completely. So once this thing happens, that particular B cell can never produce IgM, because IgM does not exist in that chromosome anymore. It is deleted, or in the next replication time, it is go away. It is not going to be found in chromosome. Here, if this mu and alpha recombine, all the constant domain present in between will be eliminated, and our product will be IgA. Same VDJ. So specificity or affinity of the antibody is not going to change, but the constant domain will change. Production will be IgA, right? It can happen in one step or it can happen in multiple steps. So first this recombination happens, and if B cell or the immune system realize that okay, IgG is not the right one, I need alpha for certain region, because alpha is the only secretory antibody. Alpha dimer, which you saw in last lecture, the dimer of IgA is secretory. It can cross the epithelial barrier. Okay, so if there is any immunity we need in elementary canal, it should be IgA. IgM cannot cross that, IgG cannot. So IgA can cross the epithelial barrier and it can come into the elementary canal. So to protect us in the mucosal region or elementary canal, IgA is the only antibody. So if there is any infection there, IgM, IgG cannot help us, right? So we need Ig alpha. So IgA we need. So initially in the secondary infection, if even IgM converted to IgG, it may undergo further rearrangement or further recombination, and then from gamma and alpha can recombine and can again produce IgA. So it can be directly. So if cell, if our body or immune system realize that IgA is the only thing, there is no other alternative, it can happen directly from IgM to IgA, or it can undergo some other isotype or sub-isotype and then realize, no, this is not enough, we need some more. So some cell can undergo to IgA, some remain same. So what will happen? Same antibody specific to, or specificity is same, affinity is same, specific to a particular antigen can have two different isotypes. It can be IgG or IgA, or IgG and IgA both. Okay, but normally once IgM converted to something else, there will be no IgM production from that particular B cell, because IgM part is the first constant element which will be deleted. So similar what we discussed in VDJ recombination time, a similar mechanism of recombination. It's a homologous recombination, and all other like cutting, joining, ligation, all these things is going to happen, which is a common for all recombination process. And this phenomena is called isotype switching. Okay, and this is S stands for S mu, S delta, S beta is switch signal. In case of VDG recombination, we used to say RSS, right? Recombination signal sequence. Here we say switch signal. That means isotype switching signal, S mu, S delta. Okay. Hope it is clear to you. Next, we will see some little more information I think I should give you regarding antibody structure, so that we can conclude like antibody for the time. During humoral immunity, during B cell mediated immunity, the similar thing will come, and we will see that how exactly IgA is converted to IgG is converted to IgA, or IgM is converted to IgG, when it is required. That detail we learn during B cell immunity time, when we will discuss that. So now there are three things we have to remember. Okay, first, this we discussed isotypic difference. That means constant, the variable region are same, only the constant region are different. Like one is IgG, another is IgA. Color code wise, it is one is blue, another is red. Is just to tell you distinguishing that change is only in the constant element. This is isotypic difference. The two isotypes. Okay, but it is possible, or it is it is very common that both are IgG, but two different alleles. Okay, both are IgG, but two different alleles of IgG. That means they are almost similar, maybe a very little change in their sequence. So it is allelic difference. Okay. Both isotypes are IgG, but they are from two different alleles. If it is happening, then what will happen? We will see both are blue, but a very limited portion of this IgG or a constant domain is different. Then this type of difference are called allotypic difference. When it will happen? So my IgG and any one of your IgG, both are IgG. But if you compare the sequence, then it will be slightly different. Okay. It's not exactly matching or 100% matching, but both are IgG isotypes, then it is called allotypic difference. That means the alleles are different. Okay. And the third thing is very important to remember and understand. It's very easy. It is called idiotypic difference. Idiotypic difference. Why important? I will tell. Both are IgG. Where is the variation? Their variable region are different. That means two IgG raised or specific for two different antigens. In my body or any of your body, if you take two IgG, constant region will be same. Say IgG 1. Okay. Constant region is exactly same because same gene is contributing. But two antibody for, developed against two different antigen, what will be the variation? Variation will be only this variable region, okay, or hyper variable region, these two are same, but this variable region are different. If you consider this one and this one are not same. This is called idiotypic difference. Okay. Idiotypic difference is not that common in discussing, but one terminology in immunology is very common. It is called anti-idiotype. Okay. Which is anti-idiotype. Anti-idiotype. What is that? If you understand it, this means you understand already a good part of immunology. What will happen if horse antibody is injected to my blood? Horse antibody, say IgG from horse purified and injected into my blood. What will happen? Horse protein is not my protein. Maybe it is antibody, maybe it is IgG. But my immune system or our immune system will recognize that antibody as a foreign molecule. Okay. And within 7 days, you know why I am talking about 7 days. Within 7 days or just after 7 days, my immune system will produce antibody against that antibody. Okay, so now I am making this just one part, like if this is the antibody variable region. Okay, I am just making this my life simple. This is the antibody, this is horse antibody. If I inject this antibody in my blood, what will happen? My blood will produce another antibody. What will be that antibody? That antibody will be like this. So that it can bind. It can just fit. So, if this is idiotype, this will call anti-idiotype. This is anti-idiotype. Okay. Why it is important? This is why it's very common, because what is happening, see, if there is infection will grow, our immune system will grow, it will take time, but they can manage with time. That, you know, is a very common, I mean, I used to say in the class, and I heard many times in different places, the immune system has a virus infection. Okay, virus infection, normal virus infection, if there is not a very different type, say HIV, but normal, say cold infection. It's normally we say during cold infection, it is taken care by our immune system. There is no drug for cold virus, because we cannot kill virus by treatment, because virus grow inside our own cell. If you want to kill virus, you have to kill our own cell also, right? And so that is normally not expected. So you cannot say like, okay, you kill the virus and the patient is also dead. So that is, no one wants that. But our immune system can handle that. And it is a very common say, like in cold, if you take medicine, if you take medicine in cold infection, you will be cured by a week, 1 week only. But if you don't take medicine, it will take 7 days. Okay. 7 days is because you need to produce antibody against that virus, and gradually it will go away. Cytotoxic T cell will take care, it will kill. So all this adaptive immunity will take 7 days. So that's why basically there is no difference, right? 1 week and 7 days are same. But this is not possible. We cannot rely on our immune system if there is a snake bite. If there is a snake bite, we cannot rely on our immune system, because snake poisons or snake venoms are so strong, we cannot wait 7 days to immune system to react or make antibody against snake venom and neutralize it. Okay. So what is going, we need? We need to inject the ready-made antibody against, already raised against that snake venom. So if snake bites, venom will be all over the blood, right? And if you inject the antibody immediately, ready-made antibody, what will happen? That antibody go and bind with the snake venom and neutralize it. So effective concentration of the snake venom in serum will be much less. But we cannot raise snake venom in human. So what happened? We normally produce this kind of anti-venom antibody in horse, because horse is a big animal. We can draw a lot of blood, we can have more antibody, because we have to cater so many human during rainy season, there are so many snake bites, right? So we need lot of antibody. If we need lot of antibody, we should not use the mouse or small animal, right? Hamster or rabbit. We use big animal so that we can have more amount of antibody. So what is happening? If you inject hot antibody against venom, which is commercially available, inject into a person who already had a snake bite, that person will be, survive, because that venom will be neutralized by the horse antibody. But body will produce antibody against that horse antibody. That is called anti-idiotype, which is very common, and that's why we cannot treat many disease in the long run. And snake venom is a single time, this kind of treatment is happening in case of tetanus. Vaccine is different, but one person already have symptoms of tetanus, that means tetanus infection happened, vaccination was not there or didn't work properly. So tetanus toxin started working on muscle, and different symptoms started. That time, anti-tetanus serum also we inject just to neutralize the tetanus toxin immediately. And this will also be neutralized again by antibody produced, and this is anti-idiotype. Okay. So anti-idiotype production is a common thing, and which is very common in medical field. That's why I explain, okay, this is what is this idiotypic difference. So I told all this story and all this fact because you can remember idiotypic difference. It is not always, I mean, otherwise you don't have to, I mean, you have to memorize it, you have to read and think. See, isotypic difference, we have talked so much, you know. Allotypic difference, I hope you understand, because between two individuals, alleles are different. So both are IgG, there is a slight difference in allele. What the sequence, it is allotypic. And this is what I said, this is the anti-idiotypic difference. And this is the practical use of, because there are a lot of, I mean, this is, I mean, more importantly, what I can say is, there are disease called autoimmune disease. By name, most of you can understand. By name, most of you can understand. Autoimmune disease means when our immune system cannot recognize our own protein. Variety, I mean, we'll discuss autoimmune disease, but one of the common cause of autoimmune disease is our immune system is producing antibody against our own protein. Our immune system is producing antibody against our own protein. Say, for example, you know insulin. What insulin is doing? When blood glucose go high, insulin is secreted and it gives a signal and a lot of metabolism reaction starts, some metabolism reaction stops. So insulin has a role. I'm not going detail in insulin activity because the time will go away. So insulin has a role. So if any individual or immune system of any individual person thinks that insulin is foreign or started producing antibody, what will happen? Insulin will be produced, but antibody will go and bind it. So insulin cannot do its function, right? So insulin cannot do its function. So that is a big problem. So you'll see severe diabetes. Because no insulin is available to do its job. And in this kind of disease or problem, you cannot add insulin from outside also, because it will be no use. Same antibody will go and bind it. So immediately what idea can come, okay, why not we put antibody against that antibody so that it cannot bind insulin anymore. Am I clear? So I can add antibody against that antibody so that two antibody bind and neutralize, so insulin will remain free. No, it's not that easy. There is another problem that you can understand, that antibody will go bind to the receptor also. That will cause a different problem. If I just, for the timing, if I ignore that problem, what will happen? Maybe 7 days it will okay, because the antibody I injected to neutralize the anti-insulin antibody is going to work. But our immune system will produce anti-idiotype. Am I clear? So there is an anti-idiotype against insulin. Okay, then you introduce another antibody against this, okay. So, I mean, against this idiotype, which will neutralize, our body will produce anti-antibody against this. This is anti-idiotype, okay. So, that means this terminology, idiotype, is very, very common in medical field, and you should understand what does it mean, because this is the just very simple logic. If you imagine, one thing I will also suggest, with this class, whatever I am telling, showing you pictures, I will try to correlate this thing, like what I said, like if you need division to understand before you do addition is very tough. Same way, we are this discrete way we are explaining different part of immune system, then we'll put them together. What you can do, you can also do the same thing. Always after the class, you read the book, please, and try to imagine what is happening. You just try to make the relationship between everything. Like this story, like insulin, anti-insulin antibody, anti-anti-insulin antibody, how this thing happened. Just draw a picture and get some idea. It will be very, very clear. And once you can understand and draw by yourself all these slides, thing, it will be, I mean, you will remember forever. So you don't have to read the book anymore, because it is just few concepts, few images, because we don't know exactly what is happening. Okay. So this is for today. See you in the next class. Thank you very much.